under here.
And let's see. Finishing off with espresso along the front at Arromanches. The other days it's probably been a little bit too cool to sit here, but today it's perfect. So, saying goodbye to Arromanches and the Normandy coast.
Still recording. So, hopefully this is all going to work. So, I'm now basically off to Ranville and Pegasus Bridge. Now I have to just take a few photos and last bit of the journey, and yeah, lots of trouble with these gloves getting them over the sleeves. Right. Moment to check all is well, bike is warmed up, we have fuel thing up. Mm. 30 zone, which is pretty much everywhere in small towns and villages here. It's not good speed for low speed with this bike. It's just not quite second, it's not quite third. Left 100 metres. It's just there. So, not quite sure who's got prior to this junction. I think I have. Ahead. Naughty, naughty, naughty. Second time that's happened in this area, but that's been the only driving misbehaviour I've seen from the French. That's on balance a little bit better than the Brits. So 140 metres, we turn right, just beyond this picnic area, and I recognise this road. Check that there's cars going, nothing behind me.
So, on this final leg of my Normandy trip, where I'm heading back from Arromanches to the ferry port via Ranville and the Pegasus Bridge, I'd just like to share some thoughts on the trip, my emotional state, and I'll sprinkle in some photos I collected along the way of things that were interesting. So it's been a little bit emotional for lots of reasons, partly to do with making this trip as a promise to my mother, partly due to sad memories of my father who passed away 2 years ago. And let me stress, he wasn't a Normandy veteran himself. He was 90 years old, so just too young for the war at the time. But he was a well-loved and respected teacher and deputy head teacher in a Catholic school in Peterborough, which he helped to found and taught for 27 years there, never wanting to move because he was so settled in the place. So, yes. It was a rewarding trip. I found my objectives both at Lyon-sur-Mer and at Vers-sur-Mer. And as you will see at the end of the trip, there was one final discovery, which I was delighted to see. But it was very tiring. Although the distances were not excessive, I was on my own. It's the first time I've taken such a trip on a motorcycle in quite a few years. Would I do it again? Yes, I think I would. It has given me some confidence, which I have been sadly lacking. And that brings me on to my general mental state, which for the last few months has been quite low. I am receiving some support for that from work, but generally I have been struggling with motivation. So to achieve a task like this has been very helpful. Now I'll stop talking in a minute and let you enjoy the sweeping roads in the Normandy countryside, almost deserted with the wheat ripening on either side. For those of us who live in England, the French roads are always a revelation because our country is so crowded and France is such a much bigger country. And although this is in a corner of France that has industrialised areas such as the ports and cities not too far away, once you get out into the countryside, things are very different. The villages are picturesque, the roads are empty, and there is much to be seen. So I'm heading back, as I said, to the ferry, but I'm going to stop at Ranville, the Pegasus Bridge, have some lunch, and then get on board for a long ferry crossing followed by a 200 mile ride home. But what I also intend to do, if the stars align, is to take a brief stop at the Portsmouth Naval Memorial and find the last missing link, which is he there? So thanks for watching this combination motorcycle travelogue with photographs. Does it work for you? It certainly works for me, but you might find the motorcycle bits boring, or you might find the bits about the war history boring. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. All feedback, positive and constructive criticism, welcome. Please no rudeness or facile comments, we get enough of those. Let's be thoughtful. What are your thoughts on memorials? What are your thoughts on, you know, our respect for the older generation who've now passed away? Or are passing away? What else can we do to stop these things happening again? And what should we be doing now? Anyway, I'll stop now. And as I said, thanks very much for watching. See you in the next one.
been following a pair of classic cars. There's a Ford of some kind, it's not a Mustang, and a Jaguar XJS. A Jaguar XJS is a pretty big car, but it looks tiny next to the Ford, which is a convertible. I tried to think of the fuel consumption of the Ford, though, in the single digits. Price of fuel, with like a pound a mile or something. Right, straight over this roundabout. We're in the middle of a big industrial commercial area. I'd never be able to find anything I've lived in Palms. None of it seems to make any sense. Seems to turn it off. I guess this might only be countryside at the wrong time. Oh, that's not this one actually. Bollocks me handsome. It's not this one. Mistake. Next one. Maybe it's even that one. This one. Another roundabout straight over, and then we're practically on the Pegasus Bridge. Maybe there's somewhere we can explore. What a new building going on here. It's all very much becoming part of France. Industrialized Memorial Pegasus. So this is it. God, gotta be able to pull off somewhere near here.
Okay, so we are finally at the famed Pegasus Bridge that was fought over so hard during the Normandy landings. I think this is one of the first places to be taken. I'll stick some info up. But this is recording because it's a very, very busy road. As you might imagine, still, even though it's, I think, no longer the main crossing over this pretty wide river. So I'll flip this round so you can actually see what I'm talking about rather than my ugly mug. So there it is, and most gratifyingly, there is a cafe. So I can stop and have a drink and bite to eat, maybe. At least a snack. There it is. Yeah, so there it is. First house in France to be liberated. And yeah. These guys take an advantage in part, even closer. Pretty smart looking bikes. I do like those kind of big, brutal old full cylinder bikes. Completely unnecessary and irrelevant, but so you can see, this is a wide river. So there's cafes and restaurants both sides, but other than that, fairly low key. I think we'll just do a crossing. I think there is a memorial the other side. So there's the info. There's a couple of pictures of actually what it was at the time. So yes, by modern standards, this is not a big bridge. But back in the day, it would have been absolutely essential. You're not going to swim that river. It's too deep, it's too wide. You're not going to get floating pontoons easily across it either. So yeah, take the bridge and you're on your way. I think this is what they call a lifting bridge. In other words, flips up when a boat arrives. As you can see, traffic levels are insane. So there we go. So I'm just about at the point where I'm symbolically crossed the bridge. Take a couple of photos. Go back, have a drink. A little bite of something. So there is the bridge mechanism. Pretty simple, isn't it? It's like a great big chain, maybe in reverse. How they manage to power it. Still, the memorials, that would have been, I guess, a German defence. Yeah, firing across the river there. So there it is. Hey, from the other side, Pegasus Bridge, you can see from the people walking along it that it's not that big. But what it controlled was very important. And it's certainly an ingenious design. How it works, I'd love to stay and watch, but sadly, no time.
Of the boat, so we're just manoeuvring off the berth.
So now we're pointing out to sea. I don't know what it's called. You can go up it, he says.
Portsmouth Naval Memorial. Beautiful it is too. It's very busy on a warm evening. I haven't much time here. I've got to get home to Cornwall. It's going to be a long, long ride. Statues and everything there. But I found him. I found him. Under here. Dunkerley, leading radio mechanic, in and amongst all the others. So that's a pretty good rating, isn't it? Look at all these people, hundreds of thousands, stretching all along there. And one day I'll have to come back and do a full recce from here. Just now I'm going to get back on the bike and go home. Report to my mum to say, I found Geoffery. He is commemorated here too.